is farm to table to mouth.
Doesn't get more local.
Today, we're checking out Gotham Greens, which is a modern way of farming that uses way less space, way less water, and no pesticides. And it's in that greenhouse right there on top of a Whole Foods. This is a One Small Step Spotlight. I'm so pumped to be at Gotham Greens, and we're gonna get a personal tour from Viraj Puri, the founder of Gotham. I'm so excited to just get inside and see what it's all about.
Hey, welcome to Gotham Greens. Yeah, so nice to meet you.
I feel like a lot of people in my generation as well are so fascinated by the hydroponic indoor farm, the farm of the future. So I would love to just take a look inside and learn how all the magic happens.
Yeah, absolutely. So I'm psyched to have you here. Welcome. Yeah. This is one of the coolest farms you'll see in the world.
We founded this business back in 2009 when we realized that so much fresh produce travels thousands of miles to reach consumers, right? So like a head of lettuce that we might eat in a restaurant in New York has to travel 5,000 miles to get here. So we figured there has to be a better way to do it. And high-tech greenhouses are a great way. So we formed this business plan to be able to build greenhouses in major cities to service those markets with a year-round supply of fresh, nutritious, longer-lasting, nutritionally dense produce. We built our first greenhouse in Greenpoint, Brooklyn, in 2011, actually.
Okay.
Yeah, this is one of the first greenhouses of its kind around the world. And then where we are today.
I recognize this.
Yup, this is super cool because this is the first commercial scale indoor farm of this nature actually integrated into a supermarket.
Oh, wow.
So that means all the produce that's grown here literally goes down the elevator into the produce section year round, even in the dead of winter. So it could be snowing outside and customers who shop in the store are getting farm fresh produce.
That is so genius. This is like when I'm like, we're living in the future. This is so cool. So can we go inside and check out the technology?
Let's do it. So this is a food safe environment. Okay. We take food safety really seriously. Yeah. So we're going to have you sanitize your hands, wear a hairnet because no one likes hair in their salads.
No one likes hair. Okay, let's do this.
All right, come on in.
Oh my gosh, wow. My first impression is that it's just so warm and sunny in here.
So it's a pretty high-tech facility. So we have sensors located all over that are tracking temperature, humidity, light level, CO2, oxygen, and a whole bunch of other variables. And then all that data is fed to a computer control system that we program to turn equipment on and off year round. So for example, right now, we have some supplemental lights on right now. We have some heaters that'll turn on. Obviously, we're getting all the natural radiation from the sun, which keeps these plants happy and healthy. So we keep this greenhouse in like the 70 degree range and the 70% humidity range year round. So great for people, but even better for plants. And so it allows these plants to just kind of thrive and grow in this really happy environment year round.
I wish I was a piece of lettuce. 70 degrees year round, that is like my ideal temperature.
These are very coddled plants. And as you can see, there's a lot of consistency and reliability.
Right.
And that's what, frankly, customers love. Retailers like it, chefs like it. They want to make sure they have a high quality product year round. And that's what we're able to do. So this is butter lettuce, great for wraps, great for salads.
Wow.
It holds dressing really well. We have a bunch of green leaf lettuce varieties here.
Yeah.
We have red leaf lettuce. We have arugula. We have romaine.
Wow.
We have basil.
You can smell the basil.
Yeah, basil is so fragrant.
Can we talk about what I'm seeing here? Because this is obviously so different than what you think of when you're growing plants.
Yeah, for sure. So we use a cool technique known as hydroponics.
Okay.
Right? So hydroponics literally is a Greek word that means water working.
Okay.
So there's no soil in this facility at all.
Wow.
So you might think, well, plant needs soil to grow, but it actually doesn't. It needs water, it needs nutrients, it needs sunlight, and it needs oxygen, and it needs CO2.
That is
right?
So
and
wild.
We're able to deliver that here. So we have this proprietary blend of nutrients that we dissolve in the irrigation water, and then the irrigation water fertilizes the plants. And what's also super cool is we drip irrigate everything here.
Oh my
so this
gosh.
Is like drip irrigation,
and
right?
Does this have nutrients in it?
It does, yeah. And then what's particularly sustainable and cool about this system is we actually recycle all the irrigation water for reuse. And as water becomes a more scarce resource around the world, we're confident that this form of farming is gonna have a, you know, a larger role to play. We grow everything from seed, so there's a little bit of a seedling area right here.
Wait, they're so adorable. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, these are little babies. And you know, like humans, little plants also need a little bit of extra TLC.
Oh.
So they get you know, their own lighting and their own temperature.
Wow.
And their own irrigation, their own sleep. And then once they've sort of sprouted and are a little bit larger, which I can show you in a second here.
Yeah, let's see, like a teenager plant.
So they're getting a little bit bigger. How long do they stay
in these trays? They're still nice at this age. When they get a little bit older, then watch out.
Oh yeah, they start to talk back.
Oh yeah.
And these are adorable.
These are probably like 5 days old, something like that.
Amazing how condensed everything is. Mm-hmm. Everything is like
We use space very efficiently. Yeah, that's the idea.
Yeah.
So these are seedlings that are obviously a little bit bigger, and now they're starting to crowd each other. They want to break free. And
going to house parties.
Exactly. Going away to college. And then they get transplanted.
Oh, okay.
And they get transplanted to these different growing systems here.
Wow.
Where they're just a little bit bigger. And then these are the adults that are ready to be harvested and go out into the world. Is this metaphor going on too long?
I know, we're like, and then it's a teenager.
Gets his license.
Then it's a grandparent. Okay. What I've noticed from talking to you is that there's so many benefits. It's like less land, less water, no pesticides at all.
All the products are pesticide free, which is great.
And short distance.
Exactly. Okay. And there's other things like lower carbon emissions.
Right.
We don't have to truck the stuff so long. There's not the agricultural pollution.
Right.
There's not like fertilizers and chemicals getting into the groundwater. Less food waste, right? So almost 50% of the fresh produce in this country is thrown away. So by growing like so close to the customers and giving them fresh product with longer shelf life, less gets thrown away. And then by locating our farms in urban areas, we're also able to just educate more people on this form of farming, about environmental sustainability. We bring tons of groups in for like tours, whether it's like schools, work with community gardens and classroom gardens and things like that.
Do you think that something like this is gonna be like a replacement of traditional agriculture?
Definitely not.
Yeah.
I think this is going to have a role to play in the farming system of the future. It's not going to replace super large scale farming for certain types of commodities like wheat and rice.
Right.
But I think for certain types of crops, this system is really well suited. And I think there's no like silver bullet solution that's going to like fix everything, right?
Right?
We need a bunch of different solutions, and I think this is one of them.
Can we harvest something?
Yeah, we can definitely harvest. Put on some gloves.
Okay. Look, we're putting on gloves.
So we've got some gloves, important to be clean.
Okay.
We've got some shears, and then just take a little snip right above that little cube there.
Okay.
Bam.
So easy.
That's it.
I'm a farmer now.
Have a smell.
It smells so good.
And I know we're gonna do some tasting later, but just have a little taste right now.
This is farm to table. Come out.
Doesn't get more local.
So good.
Let's go eat.
All right, let's go eat. I'm so excited. Thank you. I have all my stuff. I'm taking this off. We're gonna go taste. All right, let's do this taste test.
All right, I hope you're hungry.
I'm always hungry.
All right, let's start with some lettuce. So this is our butter lettuce.
Okay.
I know we had a shot of that earlier inside. So why don't you grab a leaf and dip it in our green goddess dressing, which is made using a lot of the fresh basil.
So good.
Right?
So good.
Just makes you want to eat plants all day long.
I mean, yes. Well, this has been so much fun. I so appreciate you giving us a behind the scenes tour. I know that our whole audience is gonna be so obsessed with learning about y'all and your technology and your mission. So thank you for all.
Thanks for visiting us. Yeah, it's been great.
Can I just take all of these with me?
All yours. Come back for more anytime.
Okay, I will, I'm going to.